When you're connected to a public Wi-Fi network, you should know by now that it's a good idea to use a VPN proxy service, such as Private Internet Access, NordVPN, CyberGhost, ProtonVPN. I mean, there's a ton of them, right? These VPN proxy services help increase both your security and privacy. But what about when you're at home? I mean, imagine not having to remember to flick on your VPN tunnel when you want to surf securely. Or perhaps you've got devices like a Roku or your favorite gaming console or that sleek smart TV that can't run your typical VPN apps. Well, here is the good news. If your VPN proxy service supports OpenVPN, you can integrate it directly into UniFi network. And you can choose exactly how your devices will utilize that VPN connection when connecting to the internet. Do you want to use your VPN proxy service for only specific devices? No problem. Or perhaps you want to use that secure connection for specific domains that you're connecting out to. You got it. Or maybe you want a full-blown network that allows any wired or wireless device to connect out through that VPN. Well, you are in luck because in this video, I'm going to show you how to configure UniFi network to cover all of these scenarios, enabling you to fully customize your privacy and security for your own home network. All right, you ready? Let's do this. By now, you've probably already heard about the Zimaboard, but if not, I'll break it down for you. The Zimaboard is a single board computer that's specifically designed to make home lab projects incredibly easy. When compared to something like a Raspberry Pi, the Zimaboard's learning curve is very small, so if you want to get up and running quickly with some awesome home lab projects such as UniFi, Nextcloud, or Pi-hole, you've basically got one-click installs for all of these projects. And not just these projects, the list of applications in the Zimaboard's built-in repository is quite impressive. The hardware is also quite impressive. It features a quad-core Celeron CPU, 2, 4, or 8 gigabytes of DDR4 RAM, and more ports than you'll even know what to do with, including USB 3, dual gigabit Ethernet, a mini display port for 4K video, dual SATA ports for external hard drives, and even a fully exposed PCI 2.0 slot. And when I say the learning curve for the Zimaboard is very small, I mean it. When I first opened up the Zimaboard, within 1 hour, I had it installed and updated. I then installed a Cloudflare Tunnels connector. I installed Nextcloud and OpenSpeedTest, and I routed both of those applications through the Cloudflare Tunnel, locked down with secure remote access, all within 1 hour. It was a breeze to set up and use, and it's absolutely a home labber's dream device. So thanks for watching, and thanks also to Zimaboard for sending me this device, as well as sponsoring this video. Links down in the description if you'd like to check them out for yourself. My demonstration network for this video is incredibly simple. I have T-Mobile home internet connected to this UniFi Dream router, and I have my laptop hardwired directly into the Dream router. As for the VPN proxy service, I'm going to be using private internet access. I have personally been using private internet access for about 5 years now, and I absolutely love the product. It's easy to install, it's easy to use, and it 100% works with UniFi network for everything that I'm going to demonstrate. So if you're thinking about getting a VPN proxy service and you find this tutorial helpful, please help support the channel by using my affiliate link for private internet access down in the description below. That link gets you private internet access for as low as $2.03 per month, plus 4 months free. It's actually really a great deal. That being said, even though I'm using private internet access for this tutorial, any VPN proxy service that supports OpenVPN connections should work the same way. I have also created a complete step-by-step guide for everything that I'm showing in this video in order to make your life easier. The link to that blog post is also down in the description below. Following along with that blog post, the first step is to log into private internet access and generate our OpenVPN configuration file. Within the private internet access dashboard, you want to click on Downloads, and then scroll all the way to the bottom. And here you're gonna see the OpenVPN configuration generator. Go ahead and click on that link. So this allows us to create our .ovpn file, which is going to later be uploaded into UniFi network. OpenVPN 2.4 or newer is fine. I'm actually gonna click Linux for platform, although I'm not even sure that it matters. I've tested it with Linux and it works fine, but I haven't tested with any of these other configuration options. And then you wanna choose your region. And of course you can pick whatever region you want, but for the best latency, you probably wanna pick a location that's relatively, you know, geographically close to where you are. So for me, on the west coast of the US, I'm gonna pick US West. Now, there's also this US West streaming optimized server. So when you go to something like Hulu or Netflix, oftentimes those services will block VPN proxy service IP addresses. Like, they know about NordVPN and private internet access, right? And they don't want people using those services to stream their content. So they will block those IPs. However, the US West and US East streaming optimized servers for private internet access are kind of made for that situation. Now, again, full disclosure, I have not tested it, but if you are going to be setting up UniFi Network for something like Netflix or Hulu in order to stream content from a different country or something like that, that's probably the option that you want to choose here. And again, your mileage may vary. I don't know exactly how well it works, but I know with like US West, if I try to go to Hulu from that private internet access IP address, it gives me a warning and tells me it's not allowed. Okay, so US West, and then everything else we're gonna leave default, and I'm just gonna hit generate. So that's done. We also are gonna need to know our private internet access username and password. Let's go ahead and get all of that input into UniFi Network next. From the dashboard of UniFi Network, I wanna click on settings, and then we're gonna click on teleport and VPN, and then we are going to click on the VPN client tab. So here we're gonna add a name. I'm gonna say private internet access US West. Then I'm gonna fill in my private internet access username and password. And then finally, we're gonna upload that OpenVPN configuration file that we just downloaded. Okay, now we're gonna say test and save. And notice down here in the bottom corner, we have these sort of three blinky lights that are just sort of thinking and thinking and thinking. I have found that this actually never resolves. So what you can do is click test and save. I'd wait about a minute or two and then click off of the teleport and VPN setting and then click back in, and you should see that that VPN server connection has been established. While we're waiting for that connection to establish, let's talk about the three different scenarios that I am going to be configuring for use with private internet access on UniFi Network. So there are three, there's many ways that you can skin this cat, right? But the ways that I'm gonna show you are device specific, domain specific, and then full network security or full network privacy. So when I say device specific, I mean that we're gonna have the ability to say, for my iPhone or for my laptop or for my Roku, always use this VPN client connection. For domain specific, that means I can set which domains, when I surf out to a particular domain, which domains are going to always use the private internet access connection. And then for the full network setup, we're going to be creating a completely separate network VLAN where any wired or wireless traffic that is on that particular network or SSID will be using that VPN client connection out through private internet access. So we're going to set all of that up in this video. And again, full step-by-step instructions are in the blog post. Okay, so our connection has now been established, as you can see right here. OpenVPN client connection, we've got an uptime of about 3.5 minutes. Perfect, we are good to go. We can now utilize this VPN client connection in UniFi Network. So let's set up that device specific rule first. So I've got my iPhone 13. It is connected to the wireless of the R2 Dream 2 here. Let's click on routing, and under traffic routes, we're gonna say, what do we wanna route? We're gonna say all traffic on, and then we can pick a device. So we're gonna say our Apple iPhone 13 Pro Max. You can also add multiple devices here. You don't have to create multiple rules for multiple devices. You can just add them all to this one rule. And then the interface that we're gonna use is that private internet access US West VPN client connection that I just created. And then we can give it a description, iPhone through PIA. And we're gonna click add entry. So now we've created a routing rule that says all traffic from this device goes through that VPN client connection. Let's test it out. So if I bring up something like whatismyip.com, which shows us our WAN IP address, the way that we're presenting ourselves to the internet as a whole, I can see that my location is Phoenix, Arizona, and my public IP address is 184.170.252.132. And if I go back to that VPN client connection in UniFi, I can see that the IP address matches. So that means that we are successfully sending this device through that VPN client tunnel. Let's check one more spot, and that is private internet accesses, what is my IP page, which will also show us whether we are protected with private internet access. And that is privateinternetaccess.com/what-is-my-IP. And bringing up that page, we can see the same WAN IP address, the private internet access IP address, as well as we can see that we are protected and connected to private internet access. Okay, so now onto a domain-specific routing scenario. And in order to do that, I'm gonna delete this first rule that I created. So I'm gonna go back to routing, we're gonna manage and delete that rule because I wanna make sure that I am showing this to you as clean as possible. So if we wanna route all traffic to specific domains through private internet access, it's very similar, but just a little bit different. So we're gonna create another rule, but this time we're gonna route specific traffic, and then we have a few different categories here. So IP address, region, domain name, etc. We're going to say domain name, privateinternetaccess.com, we're gonna add that one. Maybe we wanna do something like netflix.com and add that one, right? So this way, any of your smart TVs that are going out to Netflix will be using this private internet access connection. And then for devices, we're just gonna say all devices, or again, you can get more granular and pick the actual devices that are using this rule. And then the interface is our VPN connection, and we're gonna say send domains through PIA as the rule name and add entry. Let's test that on our phone again. And this time when I refresh whatismyip.com, I get the T-Mobile home internet WAN IP address because whatismyip.com is not one of the domains that I listed in that rule. But if I go back to the private internet access page and refresh that one, and we can see that we are connected through PIA when we go to that specific domain. Okay, so now let's say you just wanted to create a wireless SSID that when you connect your phone out to that wireless SSID or any device in your household, it's gonna be using that VPN client connection and surfing securely, right? This way you don't have to remember to turn private internet access on and off at your device level. You can just connect to that Wi-Fi and then whatever connects to that Wi-Fi is gonna be secured. So to do that, first we're gonna delete the domain routing rule that I created. Again, we're just getting a clean slate here. And the first thing we wanna do is create a network, a VLAN, for our secure network, our secure subnet. So we're gonna say new virtual network, network name, we're gonna call it Dreamy Secure. I'm gonna uncheck auto scale network, but you can leave this on and it's gonna be totally fine. I mean, basically you can take all these defaults if you want. I personally like to set this stuff manually. So we're gonna change the network to 53.1/24. And then scrolling down, we're gonna say manual. And for DHCP server, I'm gonna set the DHCP pool so that my available IP addresses to hand out automatically to devices is from .10 through .254. I'm giving my sort of 2 through 9 available IP addresses reserved for static devices if I wanna set any devices statically. And then we also wanna be sure to set our VLAN ID to something else. Now you can leave it default. Again, all of this can be left default. I'm setting it to 53 because I like the third octet of my subnet range to equal the VLAN ID. So we're gonna say VLAN ID 53 and save those changes. So now we need to create a wireless SSID on top of VLAN 53, the network that we just created. So we're gonna say Wi-Fi and create new. We're gonna call this Dreamy Secure and give it a nice strong password. I'm doing 123456789. Don't use that, that's just for my demonstration. The network that we're going to choose is Dreamy Secure VLAN ID 53, the one that we just created. And that's it. We can just say add Wi-Fi network. So now I have a wireless SSID, Dreamy Secure, that is layered on top of a new subnet, VLAN ID 53. But we're not using that VPN client connection yet. So let's go ahead and make another routing rule. So we're gonna say routing. We're gonna say all traffic on Dreamy Secure, so our Dreamy Secure network that we just created, is gonna go out through private internet access US West. So we're gonna say secure network through PIA, and we're gonna say add entry. Keep in mind also, anytime you do these types of routing and firewall changes in UniFi, it does take a little bit to take effect. Give it a minute or two. If it's not working, it should start working eventually. Okay, so now I have connected my smartphone to that Dreamy Secure network. And let's refresh our private internet access page, and we can see that we are protected. If I go to whatismyip.com, we can also see that we are coming from Phoenix, Arizona with an IP address that is our private internet access IP. So that has worked, right? All of this being said, the OpenVPN connection out to private internet access is a little bit fickle, okay? So it's not always gonna work 100%. If there's ever a problem with it, you can just go into your teleport and VPN and VPN client, and then you should be able to sort of, hit apply again and it'll reconnect. Sometimes it is going to get disconnected. That's just the nature of any of these VPN proxy services. So just keep that in mind. Also, one final thing to keep in mind, whenever you set up a new network like this, a VPN network or a secure network like we created here, within UniFi, these networks are always open to each other. So I have three networks in this Dream Router. I have my main sort of default LAN, I have a guest network, and I have now created a secure network called Dreamy Secure. Every device in every one of those networks can see the other devices in the other networks, right? Because it is permissive, it is open by default. So what you wanna do is create some firewall rules to flip that on its head, right? You wanna make it blocked by default, and then you wanna specifically allow what traffic can go to which networks. And I'm not gonna cover that in this video. It's just like basically like just a few firewall rules. But in my last VPN video, I covered that pretty extensively. So go check out that video. I'll put a link to it down below. There is also a link to that video in the blog post, as well as full step-by-step instructions for everything that I did here today. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my recent UniFi VPN video. You can just click on that and go watch that as well. And the bottom video is my recent video on a different type of VPN, how to set up Cloudflare tunnels.